Welcome to ETDs. Understand your options before clicking submit. This is video number 4, Embargoes. If you are concerned about making your thesis or dissertation openly available to scholars, researchers, and others through ProQuest and Digital Georgetown, you may request an embargo, delaying the public release of your work. Reasons for requesting an embargo might include: you do not wish to make public information about a pending patent application. Release of your work may violate someone's privacy rights. You do not wish to disclose sensitive data or information. Or release of your work might adversely affect your chances of publishing your revised dissertation as a book. If your concerns fall into one of these categories, you should consult with your advisor and committee to determine whether an embargo would be appropriate. To ensure full protection, you must separately request embargoes from ProQuest for their dissertations and theses database and from the Graduate School for Digital Georgetown. The Graduate School offers two types of embargoes: the common embargo and the restrictive embargo, and also for three time frames: 6 months, 1 year, and 2 years. With a common embargo, the full text will be available in Digital Georgetown only to Georgetown University faculty, staff, and students with net IDs, and upon request to readers who are on site in Lowinger Library. If a restrictive embargo is approved for your work, the full text of your work will not be available to anyone. This more restrictive option must be supported by a letter from your mentor or the director of graduate studies. To request that your work be embargoed in Digital Georgetown, send your request to gradstudentservices@georgetown.edu. Once submitted, the embargo request is reviewed by the Graduate School according to the embargo policy as set out in the Graduate Bulletin under Publication of Theses and Dissertations. ProQuest embargoes are also available for 6 months, 1 year, and 2 years. To request an embargo for your work in ProQuest, fill out the appropriate section of the ProQuest online submission form. Note that for both types of embargoes, the metadata and abstract will appear in both Digital Georgetown and ProQuest, but the full text will not be openly available for viewing, printing, or downloading. In rare circumstances, an extension beyond 2 years may be granted. If you wish to request an extension, your request must be made before the expiration of the previously granted embargo and must be addressed in writing to the Associate Dean of the Graduate School. In the case of a restrictive embargo, it must be accompanied by a letter of support from your mentor or the Director of Graduate Studies. The decision whether or not to grant such an extension will rest with the Graduate School. Requests to extend an embargo in ProQuest should be made directly to ProQuest through their website at support.proquest.com. If you submit your thesis or dissertation through the ProQuest submission portal without requesting an embargo, your work will be made openly available in Digital Georgetown within a few weeks after graduation. Requests to embargo a work that has already been publicly available must be made to the Graduate School and will generally not be approved. Even if a later embargo is approved, it is important to note that once your work has been made freely available in Digital Georgetown, any downloads or copies already made won't be affected by the later embargo. For more information about embargoes, visit the Graduate School's Embargo Policy page.